What is good, everyone? As you can see, we just woke up. We're gonna take the kids to school, and then we're gonna just continue showing you what the rest of the day would look like till obviously the match. So hopefully you guys enjoy the day that we're gonna have, and hopefully this will turn out good. And yeah, and hopefully by the end of the day, this hair won't be standing up. But yeah, hopefully you guys have fun. Dynamo game tonight against San Jose. Should be raining all day, so it's gonna be all wet and muddy, and well, it's not gonna be muddy, but it's gonna be all mushy and wet and stuff. So we'll see what goes on, and we'll see what we can get out of today. So hopefully you guys enjoy, and we'll see you in a minute. All right, y'all, so we just dropped off all the kids, all three kids, as you can see, empty back. So we're gonna put some gas in this car because it's about to die on me, like if it was a phone. And then we're gonna head straight to East Downtown, Houston, Texas, where all the magic is gonna go down. Hopefully we'll get a good video going. So see you guys later. Hopefully you guys can hear me. So we have arrived to the stadium. We're gonna make our way. So here, let me turn the camera around so you guys can see it. Can we turn the camera around? I don't think so, but basically we are right here at the stadium. Here, let me see. We just got here, so we're gonna make our way down to the crosswalk, and we'll spin around one time around the stadium. And then we'll go in and take our seats. So hopefully you guys enjoy it. And yeah, we'll see you guys when we go around here in a minute. All right, y'all. So we are here in the front of the stadium, as you can see on the north side of it. So this is what we run into. It's your team store right there. And then if you just keep going around and pan around and hold it down, and your slogan for the team, those are your tickets, or where you buy your tickets and stuff like that. So let me just show you where we're at right now. So I'm gonna pass through here. We probably can't, but it is what it is. So I'm not much of a vlogger per se, but here, let me show you around the, but you know, today it is what it is. I'm usually, funny enough, I'm a shy person, but today, you know what, we're gonna take that shyness away, and we're just gonna walk through and show you a little bit of what we're working with here. So hopefully you guys enjoy it, and you guys think it's cool. So we're about to make the turn. We got the metro rail that literally, it's like a brand new thing if you see over there. That's actually the Minute Maid. That's where the Astros play. So you basically got the rail literally right in front of the stadium. You have the station, so you can come in through this door right here, go around. So we're gonna go around. The cool thing about the stadium is that so it's like right in the heart of the city, basically. It's literally right outside downtown, which is over there, right? So you know, they have the COVID precautions, so there's like a bunch of steps to get into the stadium. So this is probably like the main gate. If I'm not mistaken, this is gate 76. Yeah, 76 gate, actually. And this is a very lovely and like very modern kind of stadium, you know, because literally right in front of it, you have, this would be what, the east side of it, the west side of it. You have like apartments and housing units, well, not housing units, but apartments. Look, let's get up close to the stadium a little bit. Look at the design. So they came up with this, I can't remember who designed it, but basically it's like a like modern type esque. I mean, I don't know if you can see it, but this is basically an orange wall right here. But basically, the stadium is. Let me see. Let me flip it around to me for a second. So basically, the stadium is. It's like designed to like a modern type theme. It looks like a cage if you look at it from one way, but we'll figure it out, see who made it, because I think whoever came up with it also did a couple other things, like a bunch of other stadiums, so they kind of look similar in a way. Something new also that they implemented now is Lexus Club. So basically, if you have a Lexus, you get to come in, not for free, but you get to, I think you get like discounts and stuff like that. But here, we're gonna go through here. We're gonna spin around because we only have 1 hour till the game starts. And you know, we have to do all the stuff, all the ticketing. You know, this is like a VIP entrance on the side of the building, basically. And that's where you get all your good stuff. So we're gonna pan out because this is a bunch of just greenery and buildings and orange walls. So we're gonna get off here and then come on in just a second to when we get to the next gate. So only a few steps where we were from down there, we come to this other gate, which is the southwest corner of it. It's called the Hustletown Gate. And it's funny because Hustletown is basically like a conglomeration of all the supporter groups and stuff like that, right? And then you have this beautiful walkway that at the end of it you have like Pitch 25, you have King's Court and a bunch of other restaurants and bars where people kind of get together and stuff. So we're about to get to it. Let me show you. So just keep walking down here. You see some nice graffiti, but this is a really fun walkway. Like when you go to the stadium, so it's like very like modern-esque type thing. You know, like you include nature and like buildings and stuff like that. You know, that's what downtown Houston kind of is coming to right now. So we see some San Jose people. I guess they made the trip. I mean, it is the first game of the season, so a lot of people are gonna be making trips, stuff like that. But as you can see here, Pitch 25 is down there. That's where the Surge is actually gathering today. And then you have King's Court, where El Batazón used to gather. They actually used to gather up there in the top, and they used to like do pre-parties and stuff like that. So this is the backside of like the stadium, basically. This is like the south side. As you can see, you have like the buses and stuff where the players come in and stuff like that. These are the gates where they come in. Most of these cars right here are actually the players' cars, so it's pretty cool. I mean, you don't know whose car is what, but I guess you can assume by their number of zeros in their bank accounts, right? But you know, you have some nice cars and you have some other regular people car, I guess, from I guess the workers and stuff like that. But yeah, there's a bunch of abandoned warehouse also here. So downtown, or east downtown, if you don't know, if you don't live in Houston, so east downtown is not like it probably, I would say maybe in the last 10 years, it's become a destination, because it smells really good in here. But it's become like a destination for like remodeling. If you can see over there, there's a bunch of buildings and like a bunch of warehouses and stuff like that. So it used to be very industrial, and like in the last 10 years, I would say, it's become more and more like, not commercial, but what they call it, residential. But yeah, so it's pretty cool. What's up? So it was actually one of the players, I think it was Jalen, is one of the guys that does that plays in the academy, that was actually training with the first team. So if you guys saw a glimpse of him, I'll probably do like a, still picture of it, but so now, so as you can see, there's a bunch of other stuff here, but yeah, like I was saying, in the last like 10 years it has become a more residential side of town. As you can see, like there's a bunch of warehouses going for sale, there's a bunch of like new restaurants and new like fancy and hipsterish bars and eating areas, I guess. But I mean, it's getting pretty cool. It's become a really cool thing. Like as you can see right there, those are that apartment complex is fairly new, like very, very new. But yeah, man. Let's go ahead and take another break because we're about to get to another wall of orange, and then we'll get back on it. This is another entrance, basically, for other important people. As you can see, there's some signs and stuff like that. But basically, I think this is an entrance for like employees and people that have a little bit of more cash in their bank to come in to like, you know, get a better, I don't know if better experience, but a little bit more exclusive experience, I would say. But look at these apartments though. They're like nice. Look, they have a little walkway in between them. That's tight. But yeah, man, like we're about to get to the end, basically, of our outside tour. It's crazy because when you walk outside the stadium, I always tell people the same thing. When you walk outside the stadium, it doesn't seem like it's gonna be big. But you know, I'll walk in, whenever we're inside, you'll see how crazy big it is. Like it, you know, it seems like a tiny stadium in a way, just because, you know, of how quick you get to walk outside of it. But you know, once you get to it, it's actually very, very very big on the inside. But yeah, so we're about to go to the, so this is actually the H Town gate, and then after that we'll go into to get our tickets, I guess my ticket, my credential to go into. This is the H Town gate. Basically, this is where the supporters group gather and stuff like that, so it's pretty cool. We have the gate right there. We're about to go get our tickets. How's it going? And yeah, I wonder how long that barbecue place has been there. But yeah, man, as you can see, they've been being very careful with everything. And then this is beautiful, man. I love the life, like there's so many cars and just life out here, but it's pretty badass. But yeah, now this is the regular gate, right? And then this over here is gonna be the gate where we, the media people, I guess, we get our pass. So we're about to go in there right now. Let's see. So right here, this is gonna be the team store right here. As you can see, everybody's lined up and ready to get their stuff. Everybody's ready. Get the new gear on, get the new jersey on. A glimpse of the stadium there. But we are here, so. It's so cool here because you get so many like different things. You get to see like, you know, so many different types of like stuff going on. Oh look, they got bananas. See if I can get one, because these are different. Can I get one? Thank you so much. So we picked up another bandana. We're gonna show it to the people. Basically, opening night, and it has like the stadium, Dynamo logo. Welcome to BBVA. Pretty badass. That's what's up. I actually thought it was gonna be the same bandana from last year, or not from last year, but the one that they were giving away, but it isn't, so we're cool over here, we're chilling. But yeah, man, I've been saying yeah, man, a lot. So we're about to get to a really cool part, which is like the, I don't know if you guys remember that I mentioned the VIP part of the stadium. So this is where we're about to get to. So surprisingly enough, nobody has told me anything about recording, so that's pretty cool. So hopefully we don't get anybody telling us anything. But yeah, this is the Lexus Club. I don't know if you guys remember, it was on the west side of the stadium. So basically everything Lexus related. I think if you have a Lexus, you get like a discount and stuff like that I was saying. But look, they got obviously an orange Lexus to go with the club, Lexus Club. And obviously that's the door right there. So you get a quick entrance to go. And I'm sure you get a bunch of parts and stuff like that to go with it. So that's part the President Club right there. So basically you get the fancy stuff. You get your concessions. La Cocina, obviously. Hispanic Heritage. And then this is where you become a member of 365 member headquarters over here. And actually, we are getting close to the media room, but we're not gonna go in it. We're just gonna walk right through it, and then we're gonna come back in and I'll show you guys. I don't know if I can record that, but you know, legends of the team, not in the US, but I'm glad they have a daily there in the 2020 NWSL Cup. They got the Challenge Cup. So yeah, man, this is very, very cool. I miss this place, like, being packed. Well, I mean, let's be honest. It's never, like, fully packed, like, to capacity. Unless, like, there's an international game going. And some Central American team is playing or something like that. Or, like, a good team is playing. There's always, like, the LAFCs, the Galaxies, you know, the big names that are... that comes to town, that's when people come out usually. But like whenever Rooney came with DC United, that's when a lot of people came. But right now for 6,500 people, or 6,500 people, I mean, it's a good number. Here's the first glimpse of the area. This is actually where Glenn Davis and Eddie Robinson do their pre-match cast. And then right next to it, of course, you have the Heineken Star Bar to do stuff. But this is cool, man. You get to like drink a beer, sip your whiskey, watch a game, and stuff like that. So it's badass. Look at that. Look at that view. If you're a soccer fan, if you're a soccer player, period, if you're just a lover of stadiums, this view is unbelievable. You got the little fan shop over here on the right. We're gonna keep going. It's weird when people look at you because they know you're doing something weird. But I'm glad that nobody's being all weird and telling me to stop. So it's pretty cool. So it's probably one of the parts that has died down the most. Here's another entrance where you can like come in and eat or come into the stadium, but then you can eat right there. Stuff like that. This is the what? The hold it down is the hold down gate or whatever, if I'm not mistaken. We're gonna keep going. So I think we're about to get to where we first started. And to be honest, I was an hour in traffic and I have to pee like really, really bad. So we're gonna probably make a pit stop before we go into the field like part of the stadium, because you're already in the stadium. We need to go into the field part of the stadium. Yeah, man, I really miss this. It's been like 6 months since I've been here, and it's been like, there's the president, John Walker. How you doing, John? Say hi to the camera. How you doing, John? How are you? Hey, I say hi to the president. John is a really good guy. He's actually been making really, really good moves when it comes as a club. When it comes to the VP, that's a whole different ball game. As if you're a Dynamo fan, you should know by now. But yeah, man, I'm not recording myself because I don't want to be awkward. It's already awkward enough to record like this. But yeah, I don't want to record myself walking around. I just want to give you guys the experience of it, you know? I don't know if you ever visit it, but if you haven't, it is a place to come and chill. There's a lot of people there that are cool, so we're gonna give, so there's, I don't know, they look important, but it is what it is. So I don't know who we are. There's another, this is like the main gate that we, I don't know if you guys remember, that we were talking about. Actually, no, this is the gate that we walked in through, or right next to. So yeah, this is a 360. That's the door that we came in through right there. But yeah, this is a 360 of BBVA. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it, and there's gonna be more to come. So stay tuned. I'm gonna go pee, and I'm gonna go inside. Deuces. All right, y'all. So I don't know if you can hear me, but we are here about to go into the field. I'm about to show you basically where the supporter section is. So we're gonna flip it around. This is a beautiful stadium. Basically right there, right behind me, is where the Dynamo supporter groups hang out, basically. That's where they chant, they sing, they do everything that they do, you know? But yeah, man, look at this beautiful grass. It's gorgeous. Alright, what's up, y'all? So first half just finished. We are here in the press booth section, as you can see. Game is 1-0. Memo Rodriguez scored the first goal, of course. So we're gonna hang out here for a minute and see how it's gonna start. The second half will be good. But yeah, man, this is the press booth, or like the press tables outside. On the inside, I don't know if you guys can see a little bit, but that's where all the magic happens, where all the real journalists go and hang out. But for now, you know, this is where we hang out and chill. So yeah, it's a beautiful view. So hopefully you guys are enjoying this experience with me. And we'll see you guys in the beginning of the game. Or not the beginning, the end of the game. Once again, victory for the Houston Dynamo, 2-1. Thank y'all for coming with me in this little adventure. I think it's time to go home. Congratulations for making it this far, as the song says in the background. Thank you for rocking with me. Thank you for, like I said, once again, joining the video with me. And hopefully we'll have more videos like this and better videos like this, so you guys can enjoy this beautiful place and this beautiful stadium. So don't forget, check out QuattroQuattroDos on the YouTube, on the Instagram, and on the Twitter. And, you know, hopefully you guys enjoy it. So, you know, share it, like it, whatever you have to do. And, yeah, see you guys later on the next adventure of the...
Second cup of coffee already. Yeah, up in the lane like I'm ready. Streets when I love you, they deadly.